Hi, I'm Mike Redding from Google Apps in edu.com, and today I'm going to show you some of the new features being released by Google Forms. Okay, so to demonstrate the changes that have happened around Google Forms at the moment, one of the things you might need to do is if you're on a Google Apps for Education or Google Apps for Business account, you might need to speak to your administrator and just ask them to go into the dashboard and then click on their domain settings in the dashboard there. And then under the General tab, there is a feature called New User Features, and they need to just select Rapid Release rather than the Scheduled Release. If you're on the Scheduled Release, you might not see these changes just yet. But for those of us that are on the rapid release, you would notice that as soon as you click on the create button, that we now have some different looking icons just here. So today we're dealing with forms, so we're just going to create a form. Now, the first thing you'll notice when you create a form is that it has a bit of a startup process. It's a little bit different. Now they ask you to give the form a name, and they also want you to choose a theme. Now, you don't need to choose a theme if you don't want to, and you'll also notice that where we used to have about 97 different themes, we've probably got about 20 there now. So I'm just going to pick one at random and click OK. And the next thing you'll notice is it's got a completely different layout here. You'll notice that the toolbar up here looks different. They've added a few different features in here. You'll also notice that the send form button, that's going to do a few different things for us. Right now you'll notice that there is the question section is here now, and that looks quite different. And you've also got a confirmation page where you can leave different messages, and there's a few different options. So I'm just going to walk you through each one of those step by step and just show you the main differences. So let's have a look at the toolbar first. One of the first things you might notice is that we have this option here called Choose Response Destination. Now, previously when we created a form, Google would link the form to a spreadsheet and that would just happen automatically. Now what you can do is Google Forms can just hold the responses inside the form, or we can actually say create a new spreadsheet, and here would be the name, the title that we could give it, or we could actually just link the form to an existing spreadsheet. So there's some options in there. If you wanted to, you can just keep responses only in the forms just there. One of the other things that you might notice here is that we can now view the live form just by clicking on this button. And so there's the live form for us just there. One of the other things you might notice here with the send form, if we click this button now, here's the link to the document as per normal. The embed is as per usual, our social media. We can also send the form by adding in people's addresses. But what you might notice here is there is a share button. So by clicking on the share button, our share dialog box opens up just like they would in any other document. And we can add people's names in there. We can change their sharing permissions as per usual. So now we can collaborate on documents, which is fantastic. The other thing that you might notice is that we now have the option to customize the confirmation page. So you can customize your message just in here. Okay, so the custom message. Now, three different options that you've got here. The first one is show the link to submit another response. So if I go to the live form, and I just click on the option and click submit, there's always this this link here that says submit another response. If we want to take that away, we can do that by just unchecking that box. So I'm just going to wait for that to save. If I then go to the live form and we click submit again, it's gone there. So that could be one option if you wanted to. They could just submit one response only once. Alternatively, you might want them to edit their response. So maybe they start it and they could come back and finish it later on, or maybe they can improve on their answers. We can just click this box just here and then go to the live form, and then we can click response, and then here we get this option now to edit the response. If we click on that, you've got to just be mindful that this is a unique URL now for that particular answer. So you, the students really don't want to be sending out this URL because anybody then can go back and change their answers. What you want to do, if they want to do a new one, is click on this this link here, which will give them a shot at answering a new form altogether. The last option in here is publish and show a link to the results on this form. So if we choose that as an option and then view the form, after we click submit, what happens is that there's a link that says see the previous responses from other people. So they get to see a summary, is basically it. You can obviously, you can't see who submitted what, so it's not, I guess, giving away any confidential information. But whether or not you want to use that, that's an option up to you. The way the form works is pretty similar to how it used to work, slightly different layout. We've got the three editing buttons just here as per usual, and we have our title and our form description just here. Now, one of the things that you can do with this, which is fantastic, is that rather than having to type in each of your options in here, you can actually go and grab an option. So let's, out of a spreadsheet or a document, so if I just create a spreadsheet quickly, alright, so let's just create a list of options. Alright, I'm just going to pick a few of those. Let's just pick that many. I'm going to copy those and go back over to my form. If I just click on paste, you can see that that's dropped them all in there for me. So you can really quickly build out your multiple choice answers just simply by copying and pasting from a document or from a spreadsheet. Once again, question types are all the same. We can choose our different question types. Everything else is pretty much the same. If you wanted to add another question, here's where we do that, by just clicking on the Add Item button. One of the other things that you can do, if you come up here, you'll see under responses, if we click on that, we can say get a pre-filled URL. Now, when we do that, what you can do is you can go through and answer any of the questions. Just say I select brown and then click submit. Then Google gives you a special URL where this document here is already pre-populated with all the different answers. So if I just click on that, you can see that it's there. Now, the people can change it if they want, but if you were creating a form that wasn't to do a test, for instance, and you pretty much knew what the answer was going to be, you could pre-populate a lot of the cells for the people straight away just by doing that, and then you just share that particular URL with them. So that could be a really handy response. The other thing that I wanted to show you in here with the responses is that, as per usual, you can see summary responses, and we can have stop accepting responses at a particular time, which could be quite handy, especially if you're doing a test, and I'll show you how to do tests in the next video. Now, when your form is connected to a spreadsheet, if you click on the view responses, what it will do is it will take you back to your spreadsheet. If you click on the form, you can unlink the form. Now, by doing that, that could be a great option if you've created a form and you wanted to run that form with a new cohort, or it was attached to a test and you wanted to test a new batch of students and so on. If you unlink that form, what will happen is that Google will, in the form, will go back to just storing the results inside the form, and once again you can choose and create a new spreadsheet. So that's going to be a really fantastic option for down the track. So they're the main changes around Google Forms at the moment. Love the fact that you can collaborate online. Loving the fact that you can choose the destination and how the form links to spreadsheets, which is just a great option. I'm loving the fact that you can just drop in your bullet points in here and have that auto-populate. And the layout just seems to make a lot more sense. Also, just loving the fact that this custom, we can put custom messages in here and we have a bit more control over what the students or what the end user can do. Just there. So thanks for tuning in to the Google Apps in EDU updates. In the next update, I'm going to show you how we create a self-grading assessment. So really looking forward to that. If you want to find out any more tips on how you can use Google Apps for education, then please head over to the Google Apps in EDU.com website and you can find all the information there. Thanks for watching.